Hello there. Welcome to the Lockdown Lock-In. My name is Frizz Frizzle, and I'm going to be interjecting with the occasional song. Please don't stop donating because of it. Well, I guess it would be nice if I could touch your body, but I can't touch your body, because otherwise we're screwed. And I'm here to advise you of the current guidelines. Please step away from side to side. 2 meters will do. Do not cough into your hands and do not sneeze onto your nan, or else you will not like what happens next. And I recommend you wash your hands for 20 seconds and don't meet people in the bathroom for gay anonymous sex. And you shouldn't touch your face. You shouldn't touch your face. No, you shouldn't touch your face, your face, your face. Don't even touch your face, your face, your face. Baby! Let's see what's coming up during the rest of tonight.
This is a poem about the lockdown. This is a while ago now. This feels like a long time ago.
What if John Lennon were still alive today and he had not been shot? The general consensus is that that would be nice, but I dare to say that it might not.
By the was.
Ah, yes. We've been asked to do this live stream comedy fundraiser event. I don't really know what it is.
Lies.
Oh, no, we wouldn't do it live. Can't be bothered with that. We'd just record something.
Yeah, let's have a song. If you know the words to the song as well, don't join in, by the way. It's not songs of praise, all right?
This guy here, look at that. Reckons he needs 6 car park spaces. You, my friend, are a prick.
Hello! Didn't see you there. It's me, famous comedian and much-loved national treasure, Tom Little. How are you? I'm all right. Obviously, lockdown's easing now, so gigs are coming back, so that's exciting. But, still got quite an empty diary, so I've still got quite a bit of time to mess around and still got quite a bit of time to just do stupid stuff. What I've been doing lately is I've been taking old adverts and playing with them, trying to insert myself into them. That sound obscene. What I mean is stuff like this.
There are lots of teddy bears, but only one Teddy Ruxpin.
Hey, I'm a bear. I kill kids and they eat them. Understand?
Sure, Teddy.
I don't think you do, child. I'll feast on your bones.
Do you like smells? Do you like smelling? Then get yourselves down to Crazy Barry's Perfume Warehouse for the new perfume by Jean-Paul Gaultier.
I don't want you to be no slave. I don't want you to work all day.
That's something I've been doing during lockdown, but I've also, another thing I've been doing, I've got making a series of videos where I take old theme tunes from TV shows that never used to have words, and then I add my own words. So, you know, stuff like this.
Mentally prepare yourself for the Looney Tunes. It is really good and it is starting real soon.
So that's the kind of thing I've been doing, but that's all old stuff. That's not really what I want to show you tonight. What I want to show you tonight is this new thing I've done, which is taking an existing song and sing it to the tune of a different song. So, you know, it's like an old joke they're doing, like, I'm sorry I haven't a clue if you've ever listened to that. I feel like it's a sort of public domain joke. They can't sue me for this. What it is, it's this song I've taken. It's Ode to Joy by Beethoven. I'm sure you'll recognise that. It's, you know, the Clockwork Orange one, you know. But rather than sing the words to Ode to Joy, I'm singing the words to Bad Touch by the Bloodhound Gang. So, hopefully you'll find this funny.
on the Discovery Channel. You and me, baby, ain't nothing but mammals, so let's do it like they do on the Discovery Channel. Sweat, baby, sex to Texas bound me, and you do the kind of stuff that only Prince would sing about. So put your hands down my pants, and I'll bet you feel nuts. Yes, I'm Siskel, yes, I'm Ebert, and you're getting two thumbs. You had enough, the two hand touch, you want it rough, you're out of bounds. I want you smaller than one, you covered like my waffle, how's that rough? Come together, my next step, Rick's name, Texas, love it, and all stuff you are inclined. Make me rise an hour early, just like daylight savings time.
So yeah, that's what I've been doing with my day. Hope you enjoyed it. When my dad was my age, he had a full-time job, a family and a house. I've got a Twitter account and a YouTube channel. But, if you could follow me on both of them, I'd really appreciate it. That would help me out. Thanks.
Coming up now, we have a very special sketch from two of the best new stand-ups on the circuit. Tony Wright and Will Andrews have come together in their sketch group, Somali and Me, and they've recorded something very special for us that you can see right now. 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 You just can't get the staff to edit these days.
We're experiencing technical difficulties. Mark seems to have forgot that he's editing this as well as hosting it.
Now! That'll do.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
So, we've looked at all the possibilities, we ran out of the tests, and I think we can finally give you some answers, because I know it's been a tough year for you, Darren, and so you say to us that you've been experiencing these pains in your ears periodically, every now and then, kind of ringing, screeching, kind of nagging on the eardrum, and we've got the answer. You've been listening to Cardi B.
Oh, God. Is there a cure?
There is. We'd prescribe listening to anything else. Yeah. If she's anything like the Nicki Minaj virus, she should be gone within 2 to 3 years.
Well, that's good to hear.
Well, compared to her, anything is.
Hello, Mac and Joanne. Thank you for having me on this. So I wanted to do something special for you. So I decided to get a special guest on, right? And you'll recognise them. Yes, I've got Adele. The laptop. Do you get it? Like, people would think that had, like, the singer Adele, but it's actually a laptop from the company Dell. I mean, I won't lie, I'm losing faith in this opening. It's not even a Dell, even. It's a Lenovo. I don't know. I just wanted to make this video special for you guys. Like, I even tried to do, like, a dance routine with my dogs, but they're just really bad dancers, two left feet. I don't know. If you can't tell, I haven't had much, like, human interaction over the last couple of weeks. Like, all I've been doing really is walking my dogs. Like, and I try and keep it interesting, the dog walks. What I do now is, like, I pretend I'm doing, like, a puppet show. So, like, the dogs are my puppets and, like, the leads are, they're, like, strings. And, so, you know, when I'm walking them, it's like I'm doing, like, a little puppet show. It's sort of like, you know that scene in The Sound of Music with the puppets, the goat puppets? Like that, but if the goat puppets had to stop every 10 seconds to have a wee. Yeah. As well, it's sort of like, all I do is chat to my dogs in the house as well. So, like, what I do, well, sometimes I'll make, like, a weird noise to see how they react. So, like, my favourite at the moment is the pigeon noise I'll do at them. So, like, ooh, not too bad. So I'll do that, and then just see how they react. And, you know, so I'll do a, ooh, and then they're like, oh, my God, there's a pigeon in the house. And then I'm like, oh, my God, talking dogs. Yeah, let's have a song. If you know the words to the song as well, don't join in, by the way. It's not songs of praise, all right? You raise me up so I can stand on mountains
That's my favourite song about ski lifts. If you can't tell, I haven't been feeling too inspired to do any comedy writing recently. Like, to the point where I did, like, approach a writer and I was like, have you got any ideas that would fit my act? Because I'm running out. I've got to be honest, I'm running out. And they wrote this for me, the comedy writer, right? Have a listen. They were a ghostwriter. Thank you, bye.
Anna Thomas there, another excellent job by one of the rising stars of the Northwest Comedy Circuit. Am I supposed to do the next bit?
It's fine. I can take it from here, John.
Okay, excellent. Right. As you can see, this is seamlessly put together. We're having no problems whatsoever getting some working chemistry going on there.
I'll be honest. It looks like I'm reading a script here, but all my script says is the word link.
It's going to be links. We're doing tonight for the National Autistic Society. The link to donate is
top of your screen now. Beautifully done. Someone hire John Porter for the one show.
Please don't. I have to sit there and be nice to the 1975. I think I might actually fucking blow my brains out on live television.
Well, our next act is the 1975.
Yes, she did an excellent job to get them.
Incredible work.
I'm autistic, and I just get too much information.
So weird doing this kind of show without an audience, where you're thanking an act. Normally you'd have a level of applause for them. Whereas right now I'm just staring at my work uniform hung up, expecting some kind of reaction from that.
Yeah, I know what you mean. It's a little bit odd, isn't it? You say someone's name, you're waiting for the response, and then it just feels like, okay, did I do that right?
It felt weird at the beginning of the show, going, give it up for my co-host, John Porter! There's no one here to give it up for him.
Yeah, it's an odd statement, is give it up, isn't it?
Yeah, what are you giving up?
I mean, if you say give it up for Jesus Christ, then that at least makes some sort of sense.
Well, that's just the commencement of Lent.
Yeah, exactly. That's the only time it really makes any sense.
So what? That's the only time you want that phrase used now is in church service at the beginning of Lent.
I want to be clear, I'm not trying to rewrite the English language here. I'm just saying it's an odd phrase. I've never really understood why people use it.
If you wish to donate to John Porter's fundraiser to remove the phrase give it up for from the English language, please use the link at the bottom of the screen now. Little secret, that's actually the link to donate to the National Autistic Society. It's the same link.
Are you suggesting I'm taking a percentage of the profits?
Absolutely not. And I feel like I should clarify as well. Yes, I am autistic, but no, I'm not doing this just to get money myself. I don't get anything myself from the National Autistic Society. I haven't just arranged this fundraiser as a very big loophole to get money myself. If I was doing that, this would be a fundraiser to promote my Kickstarter for crisp-flavoured cereal.
That's your ambition, is it? Crisp-flavoured cereal?
Yes.
Okay, fair enough.
What, just going out there, did a bit of research.
The crisp, or like, are we talking specific crisps? Or?
Well, I did a bit of research. In a survey of 100 people, 89% of people like cereal, 95% of people like crisps. So therefore, crisp-flavoured cereal would have more sales potential than cereal.
I like you. Yeah, I like you thinking there. That's a solid market reach. Yeah, okay, I'm on board.
Deborah Meaden wasn't, so that means a lot. Thank you. Now, coming up next, we've got a legend of CBBC and Nickelodeon, the wonderful Ed Petrie, who has teamed back up with his ex-CBBC co-host, Oucho, for a very special sketch. John, you're very much the Oucho to my Ed Petrie.
Well, thank you for that, Mark. I'm quite looking forward to this.
I mean, I've said that, knowing you do not know who they are. Oucho is a talking cactus. Well, it's a sketch.
Hallos?
Oh, finally. You're a hard cactus to get hold of. Even if you are quite hard to get hold of normally, what with you being a cactus and everything.
Oh, dee. Ha ha. Go ass.
So what you been doing then?
Very, very busy.
Right. Busy doing what exactly?
The customer Dolly Fee das come das, and that's the that's nanana D, and that's the lovely moti, and the flute and hunde, and the flute and tubes.
Oh, okay, fair enough.
But the was.
Ah, yes. We've been asked to do this live stream comedy fundraiser event. I don't really know what it is.
Live?
Oh, no, we wouldn't do it live. Can't be bothered with that. We'd just record something.
So we have to ask them that's bunny.
Yeah, well, of course we have to do something funny. It's a comedy night. Not exactly going to read out a list of credit card fraud victims, are we?
I'm not dumb that does.
No, it's easy. We just tell a funny story. We make something up about a friend or family member. Everyone does it.
Oh, that's them just taught that come that's humlach moose.
No, my dad actually did that and it's not funny at all and no one should ever know about it.
Oh.
No, I mean, we tell a crazy anecdote, you know. We just lie and then we go, I swear to God, this actually happened. And then everyone falls about laughing. And then we end up on Big Night Laughs at the Apollo or whatever it's called.
Oh, dee, okay. I just had a bloody Groucho.
I didn't know you had a brother called Groucho.
That's kind of just as is.
Oh, he doesn't exist. Okay, now we're rolling. You're getting the hang of it.
I'm just invited to succulent party.
He was invited to a succulent party?
I hate that succulent.
Yeah, I know. You hate succulents.
And that's him last. Just got that just in the QSP. I'm not the best in the.
Ugh, that is such a succulent move. What are they like?
So I put this to the footage, me, it's that spoon that's bunny.
Go on, what did your brother do?
It's that spoon that's bunny.
Oh, no, it sounds funny. Then go on, tell me.
That's some love, Dita.
Go on, this is great stuff.
As first as that's push, and as death.
He threw the succulent out of his pot and he died.
That's funny.
Yeah, I'm not sure it's that funny, mate.
I hate that succulent.
Yeah, I know you hate succulents, but this is an alternative comedy night. They don't like that sort of thing. They prefer jokes at the expense of Mrs. Thatcher or Daily Mail readers. Yeah, you're punching down a bit there.
Not I push that sous-soise.
Punching sideways, whatever. I don't think it's going to go down very well. Why don't I come and see you face to face? Talk it through.
Oh, not.
Well, you're not very far away.
Not gundawas, not.
You're in the room next door. We live in the same house.
Hasam, lules, not.
Look, I don't even think plants can catch coronavirus yet. I was reading this thing on the BBC News app the other day. It's quite interesting, actually.
Talk to names, that's the first. I'm Lucy.
We're in the same household! Please, I've been getting really lonely on my own, and I think a bit of face-to-face contact could be just what the doctor ordered. Because I promise I'll stand 2 metres apart at all times, and I'm... Oh, you've gone. I'll just tell them no then, yeah?
D! In and out
home. In and out home. Hello, Frizz Frizzle here again. On Monday, I jogged on the spot. On Tuesday, jumped around a lot. On Wednesday, crouched into a ball. On Thursday, I nearly punched a wall. On Friday, I did a shadow box. On Saturday, I took the day off. On Sunday, spent the day in bed. Now it's Monday and this regime has to start again. Joe Wicks, who the fuck are you? Joe Wicks, telling me what I should do. Joe Wicks, you've got me on all fours, hurting muscles that I never knew I had before. Joe Wicks, you're taking the piss. Joe Wicks, eat some fucking crisps. Joe Wicks, now my ankle's twisted. Joe Wicks is sadomasochistic. Joe Wicks. That was a song about Joe Wicks.
All right, Harriet Dyer here. Harriet Dyer. That's how they say it, Corbel. No one ever puts the... Didn't realise there was a H at the start of my name for a long time. Harriet. That's what people say. Anyway, hello, I'm Harriet Dyer. I am from Cornwall, like I said that, do you remember that? That's why I said this guy here, look at that. Reckons he needs 6 car park spaces. You, my friend, are a prick. Leaves, very windy. Right, come on, focus. I am thank you. Thanks for having me. I haven't been out yet. If I forget that later, pop it in. My ring is very loose. Lost it for 3 weeks during this pandemic. Yeah, lost it. Panicked, actually. Got a fiance I have. Caught one. Nice, actually. Yeah, fiance. Don't say fiance. I think it sounds wanky. Wanky. Like Michael Bublé's. Booble, Michael. Wind your neck in. Do you know what I mean? In conclusion, I lost it. It turned out it was in my bra. I'd just been sort of transporting it about for 3 weeks. I thought it was silly that I've been going around in the real world for about 2 years. And I haven't with it, and I haven't lost it. And then when I'm told to not go outside, bloody lost it. Yeah. It's another peril as well of having small boobs. Because if I had the boob circumference, there wouldn't have been space for it to be residing in my brassiere for 3 weeks. Do you know what I mean? Anyway, I am Harriet. Have I said that? I think so. We're in a fleece. Wasn't going to wear a fleece. Got caught in a downpour. What is this now? Sorry. Oh, God. Oh, I'm trying to swap hands, but I've got a giant hand. So, just core strength of this wrist, please. Yes. In conclusion, I hope you're okay. That just looked like... Oh, reminded me that did. Once! Not happy about this. Once, I looked like an emu when I did that. Once, I went to, I was very ill actually, I was in hospital for a very long time, and the doctor come in, took one look at me, and he said, oh, are you here because one of your eyes is bigger than the other? No! I think it's that one. No, I don't think I'd, anyway, thank you for your custom. And for all your Tamagotchis. I'm ill. No, I... well, no! I am the... I got bipolar. A lot of people say I got other things, but I've had to put a stop to them telling me. But I... House! I've got them all. It's all right. Let's not bring any more to the table. Fucking hell! The bloody hell was... I think they're finally onto me. All of the country's ants have had a meeting and they've teamed up, shook my car. Imagine if you go outside, you couldn't see the car because, I mean, I don't know whose car this is. The door was open, it was quite windy, so we just got in. No, it's my car. So, I am at my... Well, I thought I was going to tell a story, to be honest, and I won't have the time. I'm just waffling on like an absolute muppet. My bad. In conclusion, I used to have this boyfriend years ago, Trevelyan. Don't say the names. Well, because that's not a common name. People will know. Don't say a surname. Wow, this was in Cornwall. Then I got to bloody... uni in the West Midlands, and his sister worked there. I mean, anyway, he used to say I look like Gonzo because of my nose. Remember Gonzo from the Muppets? And they stretched his arm. Well, in fact, my arms look a bit like it as well. Once I walked past these people at college and I was wearing a t-shirt, and I heard them go, look at her disgustingly long arms like E.T. the helm. Anyway, I'm at my most well, believe it or not, because I think people think that if you, I mean, I don't know why I'm telling you this, if people think, no, they do, I've got a wretched astral, people think that if you need to take medication for your brain, then there's something wrong with you, but if you've got a massive gaping cyst, you take something for that, but I was in turmoil, so I needed to take stuff from my brain, and then I didn't really want to accept it. So I come off it, and then I tried to throw myself out of a moving vehicle. And that's when you know you probably need to take something. But now, yeah, fine and dandy. I'm at my most calm that I've ever that I've ever been in my life. Only side effect, really, sea mice everywhere I go. But you know. I know they're not really there. Morning, Vicar. And once, because I do a lot of mental health gigs, and once this lady come up to me afterwards, she goes, I see mice as well. And I was like, oh, brilliant. What medication are you on? And she said, none. And I said, oh, well, you've got more of a serious issue, really. Yeah, fucked. You might want to go doctors immediately. No. So that's me, really. I mean, I've been chatting for over six minutes. I couldn't tell you one thing I said. Something about mice. Something about mice. So I'm gonna go. Big up, Mark. Harriet. Big up, Mark. No. Big up, Mark. I do believe that. It just sounded like I didn't mean, but I did. Big up, Mark. Thank you. To you and the entire human race. Well, not all of them. Some of them are pricks. But you're all right, Mark. Yeah, quite like you, actually. I'm going. Been Harriet Dyer. All the best now. All the best now. God bless. Not even religious.
A big thank you to the wonderful Harriet Dyer. And take that, John. I'm all right. Go fuck yourself. Harriet Dyer. I'm all right. Take that.
All right.
Autism is a lifelong disability which affects how people, like me, communicate and interact with the world. There are about 700,000 adults and children on the autism spectrum in the UK. And like everyone, each autistic person has their own strengths and challenges. But all of us have difficulties with communicating and interacting with other people. This could mean not speaking at all, needing longer to process information, or not understanding facial expressions. We also engage in repetitive behaviour, doing or thinking the same thing over and over. This is sometimes for fun, and sometimes to help deal with our anxiety. People on the autism spectrum can also find unexpected changes, however small, very distressing. And then there is sensory overload, where noise, smells, touch, and bright lights become very painful and overwhelming. All these challenges can make the world feel very scary and hard to understand, and sometimes send us into physical and emotional meltdowns or shutdowns. It is very important that autistic people get help from an early age. But life can become very difficult if children or adults don't get the right support or understanding. Autistic children are 3 times more likely to be excluded from school. Only 1 in 6 autistic people in the UK have a full-time job. And over a third of autistic adults have reported serious mental health problems. The National Autistic Society is the UK's leading charity for autistic people. Since 1962, we have been changing society's attitudes and transforming individuals' lives. We want to create a society that works for autistic adults and children, and with your help, we can.
Hi everyone, I'm Charlotte Cropper. First of all, just want to say thank you very much to Mark for letting me be a part of this. The National Autistic Society is an organisation that is very close to my heart. Thank you. This is a song called Baby of the Family. It's all about why being the younger sibling or the only child of the family is the best. To any eldest siblings or middle child of the family, this may bring back some painful memories. I hope you enjoy. Thanks.
Because being the youngest is a blessing, you see. My fam had some trial runs before me, so over time they lost the strict policies, and now none of them ever apply to me. So I'm sorry, not sorry, to my sisters and my bro, because I've had to deal with a lot of hardships, you know. Like, I never got to be first playing Nintendo, was always Luigi when I wanted Mario. I never got to choose what was on TV after the news, no fucking glee. But I guess I got my own back in pocket money, because even though I'm 18, I'm still the baby. I'm the baby of the family. I'll never grow up, I like immortality. I'm the baby of the family. And mummy's menopausal, so she can't replace me. I'm the baby of the family. Yes. Hand-me-down clothes thrown onto the landing. Thank you, bitch, now I'm looking outstanding. Misunderstanding, she did reveal. Hey, sis, just so you know, Santa's not real. As you can imagine, I was traumatised, but instead of crying, I devised a plan, a mission, to take all the glory. If you've not already guessed it, this is that story. I may be the youngest, but I'm no one's fool. I grasped her up to mum when we were going to school, and that's why the easy chores were given to me. My sis was pissed, I was wobbling free. From day one, my fam said, be who you wanna be, just don't grow up too fast, you're our baby. I'm the baby of the family. But where would I be without my family tree? I'm the baby of the family. And all the baddest bitches that came before me, I'm the baby of the family. Yeah, I've been around for a while, so this theory ain't wild. I've put the facts together, you know, I'm the fairy child. I discovered that I was a lyrical rap goddess. I thought the only way I'm going to truly break into the industry is that I learn to play a musical instrument. So it takes 10,000 hours to master any skill. I've done 3, but I've prayed really hard. And I can honestly tell you... I can honestly tell you, I can play you whatever song you want. What's your favourite song?
Fall Out Boy Immortals.
Yeah, from Big Hero 6. Nice. Yeah, I can play that. What's your favourite song? What's your favourite song?
112
by Oasis. Oh my god, so generic. I can play that as well. Would you like to know why? It's a kazoo! You can play anything with a kazoo, because all you have to do is hum. But I learned one very important lesson on the internet. It said you have to leave the audience wanting more. And that is why I'm not going to play it. Happy Charlotte Cropper. You've been amazing. Thank you so much.
So, Darren, you're having problems with your previous illness again, are you?
Sort of. It's like the same ringing in my ears as the Cardi B virus, but this time it's got like a really sick bass line with it.
Right, okay. And is it like super hard to get out of your head, which is annoying because although you don't really understand what's going on, it's super catchy.
Yeah, that's it, yeah.
Oh, yes. I'm really sorry to say, Darren, there's no easy way to say this, but I'm afraid your diagnosis has developed into stage three.
What's that? What's stage three?
Well, stage one and two was the Nicki Minaj and Cardi B virus, but yours is worse, much, much worse. You've got Doja Cat syndrome.
Oh. If you say so.
Naming the songs already. It's worse than I thought.
What can I do to cure it?
Well, I'd start off by no longer listening to Capital Radio, as that's all they play. I'd recommend some classical to really purge your system. And within 2 to 3 months, hopefully, you'll be back to feeling like a boss bitch.
Boss bitch?
Oh, God. It's catching. Darren? Darren? God. We've got a pandemic on our hands. 2020 sucks. Oh, my God. Tell my wife and kids I love them.
A big thank you to Will and Tony from Somali and Me there. And you can see more of their sketches on their YouTube channel, including the one you've just seen will be on there very soon for you to re-watch to your heart's content.
Yeah, brilliant stuff from Somali and Me. Always enjoy watching their stuff. Guys, as we've said before, we're here tonight for the National Autistic Society. Please donate. The link will be somewhere down the bottom of the video, wherever Mark decides to put it.
There. And also, I feel like at this point we should mention that every act tonight has contributed their content completely free of charge. They're all recorded special stuff for us free of charge, and we are very grateful for that. So thank you.
Yeah, absolutely. The guys and girls involved tonight have done a tremendous job. We really appreciate the fact that they've got involved.
I'm autistic, and the fear of unexpected changes can make leaving the house impossible.
I left high school at 17, skipped out on university, lived in my parents' basement, life was sweet. My mum said I should get a job instead of living as a slob. So I went out to hand out my CV. I applied for McDonald's to serve up fries. But it turns out I was far too unqualified. To work at HMV you need at least one GCSE. But luckily for me, I found a job where I can stand around and have an attitude while selling teenagers pointless tat and shoes. I work at Claire's Accessories, the purple Claire's Accessories. My shop is filled with chubby little tweens. The boss I talk to every day is a 12-year-old called Chardonnay, whose parents are somehow younger than me. Yeah!
A big thank you to Frizz Frizzle there. Now, I don't want to insult Frizz, but John, do you agree that it's about time we had some culture?
I think culture would be a very good thing, yeah.
And by culture, I mean what is deemed to be culture by the Arts Council.
Well, I'm losing enthusiasm for this, but I'm willing to go along with it if you think it's a good idea.
Well, I will reel you back in now, as it's time for some poetry from the star of Taskmaster, Alan Partridge, Charlie Brooker's Screen Wipe, many other TV shows, and some films.
Sounds excellent. Who have we got?
We've got the incredible Tim Key coming up right now.
Fabulous.
From his own home, this is Tim Key.
This is a poem about the lockdown. This is a while ago now. This feels like a long time ago. I'll give you that. The damn pubs got shut. Mike Talk. T-O-Q-U-E. Mike Talk. Went online and ordered dartboards, beer pumps. There's a text. What have we got? Here we go. She's pleased. You can't say fairer than that. Now, this poem. Perfect, she says. The damn pubs got shut. Mike Talk, T-O-R-Q-U-E, went online and ordered dartboards, beer pumps, a blow-up barmaid, a blow-up bore, pub bore, a blow-up group of girls, beer mats, blow-up kettle chips, a blow-up urinal, a quiz machine, a blow-up fruit machine, and he had his floors redone with gnarled wood. He sat down on his blow-up bar stool and it bent in half and threw him forward onto a candle. The blow-up flame ignited his Guinness hat and threw him hard against his flesh wife. She updated her WhatsApp groups on the situation and dunked her beak back into her carbonara. That would have been about 5 weeks ago. Pub's getting closed.
Thank you there to Tim Key. And that very nicely brings us to pretty much the end of the show. Thank you so much for watching tonight's show. Thank you for donating if you have done. And thank you to all of the incredible acts for giving up their time and content for free.
Yeah, thanks very much to everybody that's been involved. It's been quite astounding watching the amount of people that have decided to get involved in this.
To play us out, the wonderful Jay Foreman.
Hello, thanks for having me. My name's Jay, and before I start, I should tell you that the main thing about me is that I'm a massive Beatles fan. In fact, because of lockdown, I've now got a haircut just like them. But this is a song about my very favourite Beatle.
What if John Lennon were still alive today and he had not been shot? The general consensus is that that would be nice, but I dare to say that it might not. He'd hang around with Bono doing Live Aid and the like. Oh, I'm glad John Lennon died. Now before you start to boo me and say that I'm a twat, perhaps I should explain. He last wrote a good song in 1971, and he never sang a decent thing again. His music in the 80s would have sounded like Crowded House. Oh, I'm glad John Lennon died. And here's a thought, imagine if he made a guest appearance as a panelist on Never Mind the Buzzcocks. His contributions would be painfully bad, and to see him look so past it would be really sad. He'd always be on Twitter making really racist jokes. Oh, I'm glad John Lennon died. Imagine if he, instead of Neil Buchanan, presented Art Attack. Oh, I'm glad John Lennon died. And by the way, I wonder, did you ever stop to think about whatever would have happened to McCartney? Everyone would still be saying Paul is dead, and they would have named the airport after him instead. In 1990, Yoko would have killed him anyway. Oh, I'm glad John Lennon died.
Sorry. Anyway, here comes the next song, and it goes like this. Bim 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 bim. Second verse, same as the first. Bim 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 bim. Third verse, same as the first and the second. Bim 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 bim. Fourth verse, similar to the first, second and third. Bim 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 bong bim 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 bong bim 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 bim. Completely different from the first, second, third, and fourth. And then I held her in my arms for the last time. Sixth verse, same as the first, second, and third. Bim, 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 bim. The end. Thank you very much. Thank you. And the next song. The next song is a song about a dream coming true. One, two, three, four.
I'm surfing with Patricia Routledge upon the waves of blue. I'm surfing with Patricia Routledge, just like I've always wanted to do. Just me and Patricia, there's nowhere cooler to be. I'm in love when Patricia's surfing with me. Miss Routledge isn't a surfer, she can't keep up with me. I'm riding all the waves and she keeps on falling into the sea. Keep trying, Patricia, you're doing marvelously. I'm in love when Patricia's surfing with me. She doesn't look too happy, she wants to be elsewhere. I know it's cold and I know it's raining, but I want that competition fair and square. So I'm surfing with Patricia Routledge, riding my cares away. And I'll be surfing with Patricia Routledge until at least the end of the day. Stop crying, Patricia, I don't want people to see. I'm in love and Patricia's surfing with me. And Patricia's surfing with me. And Patricia's surfing with me.
Thank you very much. Thank you. God, it's weird without a live audience here. Anyway, thanks very much for having me. The next song is a true story.
I paid my cleaner to kill my cat.
Thank you. And the last song, actually, before I play the last song, if it's all right with you, I'm going to do a shameless plug. If you enjoyed the songs and you want to see more, there's my website, jforeman.co.uk, which has information about gigs which may or may not be happening. Only time will tell. And I've also got a YouTube channel, youtube.com/jforeman. I'll see you there. Thank you very much indeed. Anyway, this last song goes like this.
When I'm with my club of friends, I take reluctantly whatever pills they put in my hand. And when I'm with my nerdy friends, I laugh at references I don't understand. And when I'm with my football mates, I sit there quietly and wait until they're not talking about football.
But when I'm alone, I go into my kitchen and I eat it all out. When I'm alone, I sit at my computer and I fart my brains out. When I'm alone, I click on sites you won't believe. Why am I deleting my history? Who am I trying to deceive?
And when I'm with my stoner friend, we go to munchy heaven and I eat all the jam. And when I see my ex-girlfriend, I tell her all about how happy I am. And when I'm with my political mates, I sit there quietly and I wait until they're not talking about football.
But when I'm alone, I curl up on the floor and I pretend I'm dying. When I'm alone, I masturbate at my own reflection crying. When I'm alone, I get confused and upset. I look my ex up on the internet.
La 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 la. La 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 la.
And then I make myself sick to make the voices go away, and then I eat up the sick to make the voices all come back. And when I'm alone, I see how drunk I can get. I look myself up on the internet.
Thank you very much. My name's Jay Foreman. Thank you for joining me, and goodbye. How'd you turn this thing off?